Hello everyone, my name is Sparks and this is Confronting Chaos, a series of smaller videos to serve as partners to Chaos Fight videos to help you understand enemy gimmicks, dangerous moves, and what characters are brought into the fight to do. Also, since just about every event now has synergy characters with boosted stats, I will try to understand and explain why they were chosen. With that, let's jump right into the first fight I'll be going over, the Chaos Fight for the new Act 2, Chapter 8 map. The Chaos Fight is divided into two waves with three enemies, like so. The Skull Dragon Soul and Skull Wizard in the first round, and then the Demon Wall alone in the last round. The Skull Dragon only has one HP attack that it's not going to do if it's broken, nor will it recover and perform it. However, it does have a move that'll always break you if it hits. The Skull Wizard, on the other hand, has two HP moves, one of which it'll always do after using brazenly its smirks, which can tell you to prepare. The final boss of Demon Wall itself has three HP attacks. Well, I guess four if you want to count the plus version of its recast ability. In terms of resistances, it'll absorb holy and dark damage as well as being tough to magic attacks. So no Ikos, Yuris, Zgulbezes, or Cecils here. Of its 7 attacks with brave hits, 4 are magic, 3 are physical, with 4 being single target and 3 being group. As you'd imagine, the recast ability is something to keep track of, as it breaking someone on top of a decently strong group brave attack can give the Demon Wall a lot of bravery very quickly and put your party in a scary situation if underprepared. With the enemies out of the way, let's analyze the boosted characters for this fight. Lilisette is a solid melee support, with good auras, some buffs, debuffs, and battery. The one thing she lacks for the party is healing, but that'll be covered later on. With her battery, she can help keep the party safe, and with her debuffs, she can keep the enemy's speed and attack a bit lowered as well as affecting their bravery thanks to the sap she can apply. If you have her EX available, the buff will increase party critical damage and party overflow, which combined with Leo's precision strike debuff should keep you doing good damage even late into the second wave. Galoof is an absolute champ for the first wave. Since all of the enemy HP attacks are melee based, if they're targeting Galoof, they're going to miss. Even if they're not targeting Galoof, if a party member has cover applied, he's going to step in and the monster will miss. His EX buff also reduces brave damage taken by the party. This combined with Lilisette's attack down debuffs will keep your party from getting overwhelmed by magic brave attacks. It also provides him with HP regen, covering the HP regen Lily cannot provide. On top of that, he also provides attack and embrave to the party. In fact, his embrave buff potency is even higher than Lilisette's. Don't forget that you need to use Blade Block Plus to have him counter. The base version only increases his defense and dodge chance. Finally, we have Leo. As the general jack of all trades, this man is useful throughout the whole fight. In Wave 1, his debuff will keep everyone shaving pretty effectively, helping out his and Galoof's HP damage capability. His delay and battery will be useful in a pinch, for example, if you forget to reapply Galoof's cover buff onto an ally. His EX giving him a free skill gives him good longevity, which combined with Galoof's fast recast EX and Lilisette's normal recast, if you have it, should come up just a bit faster, making him even more effective. In Wave 2, his EX cast is improved if you have his EX plus at 3 limit breaks, letting it hit for basically double. He provides Embrave auras which will work nicely with all the attack that Galoof gives out and the battery that Lily provides, and to make up for what Lily cannot provide, he provides HP regen to the party. Thanks to a rather relaxed set of elemental restrictions, you technically could bring in a magic damage unit here provided you can imperil and enchant properly. Unless you choose to run delay strats, you're probably going to need a healer for one or both rounds, but modern supports have that covered in some fashion. It should be noted that while Galoof handles single target attacks perfectly, he cannot do anything against group attacks, so the Demon Wall's recast ability will still deal HP damage to the rest of the party. He also doesn't have 100% dodge chance on magic attacks, be they group or single target. The enemies are susceptible to most debuffs, the only thing is that Demon Wall itself cannot be afflicted with defense down. The past few months have brought with them melee damage options, supports, and self-enablers. Options like 8, Vayne, or Aranea for physical damage, Ignis, Pinello, or even Ishtala for support, maybe even ones like Gao or Onion Knight since they can imperil their own element. Hopefully you've pulled somewhat recently and have a handful of team building options. For summon choices, neither Holy nor Dark are elements that we have level 30 summons for yet, so no need to worry about bringing in an ineffective element. It's probably better to summon on the second wave, higher potential damage output from Leo as well as being able to control or delay the Demon Wall. For friend unit choice, you probably can't go wrong with Aranea, but friend Leos are also understandably a choice, since a friend Leo with passives should have 5 uses of Master Blade, perfect for the friend rotation. But Shock Plus will also put out very high damage and within 5 turns, you can get out 2 of them. Advice for this fight? If you're watching this now, while the new chapter is still, well, new, do it in co-op. Yes, you can do it solo and have complete control, but co-op means up to 3 summons, which with right timing can basically shut down Demon Wall and get you with complete for the fight if you host. Like all co-op stages, you need to be the host to actually get completion marks for it. This advice is true for all new chapter chaoses moving forward. I did some co-op runs with Discord friends and the Demon Wall got in like 2, maybe 3 moves. Aside from that, keep track of the recast gauge on Demon Wall. As I mentioned earlier, someone getting broken along with a high attack group brave attack means it's more likely that someone's gonna die. With that, that should go over the main points of the new chaos fight. The enemies, the moves, the potential danger, and intended or potential team choices. As I said near the start of the video, I'm going to be linking my solo complete of this fight so you can see an example of it. And hopefully with this one acting as a companion, you'll understand some of the choices I made. I get that this boss isn't even that hard of a fight, which I think should be a good thing. Gives more players the ability to finish it. So I figured with this would be my trial run of this video type. If you like this video or think there's something I can do better, let me know. And if you're interested in more Opera Omnia content or Chaos related videos, subscribe so mine show up in your feed just a little bit quicker. With that, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.